Been a while since I did a video on Crossout. I did a lot of modifications to a lot of my builds over the course of a while. Basically, I did a lot of grinding and stuff to get a lot of the parts and weapons and everything that you see on these builds right here. So I'm going to go through each of these builds. I'm going to test them out in an easy raid just to see what they can do and what they're about, just to test their abilities and see their parameters. And what I'm going to show first is my remedy build. As you can see, these flamethrowers here, they're called remedies. Max ammo is 200 pieces, durability 400 points, 4 points of energy drain, 300 kilogram mass. I've got 3 of these. I wanted 4, but the cabin that I'm using does not allow that in excess of that, which is kind of dumb. But for the cabin, I'm using what's called the Blight. It's like a hot rod style cabin that works the best with flame and fire based weapons. It has a perk when activated for 8 seconds. It increases the fire damage of flamethrowers and artillery and temperer by 40% and flamethrower range by 50%, flame puddle size by 30%, and it changes the flame's color to green, but only for 8 seconds, and it charges while moving. But it doesn't have that good of mass limit or tonnage. It only has 4,100 kilograms of tonnage and 8,300 kilograms of total mass. So I guess 3 of these would do at the moment. And that's maximum that I can go with that. And now the mass limit is actually 9,300 kilograms because I have an extra engine on there that allows an extra 1,000 kilograms of mass limit on there. Now I'm just 10 kilograms below that, so if I exceed that, then the whole build would go a lot slower and it wouldn't perform like it was supposed to. And this build has six 66-inch monster truck tires. These are called Bigfoots, hence why it's basically a monster truck style tire. And these are 66 inches tall and 43 inches wide, and these are steering, so this is a 6x6. So it is a 6-wheel drive, but it also has 6-wheel steering, so I guess you can call it a 6x6x6. I got quite a few builds that are like this kind of style. And in the back section here, covered by these container walls and minivan panels, I have ammo packs that supply the remedy flamethrowers of extra oxygen gas, so it wouldn't run out very quickly. And underneath, I have a generator known as the Apollo. Gives you 4 extra points of energy, and you get 16 points of energy on a light cabin like this, and also medium cabins get 16 points of energy if you have that generator as well. All light and medium cabins of epic and even legendary rarity have 12 points of energy, whereas the heavy cabins have 11 points of energy, whereas if you get the Apollo generator, you get 15 points of energy max, which I'll go over momentarily. Now, I'm doing a new method on this. Basically, I'm basically screen recording my gameplay here using my Xbox app from my iPad, because I noticed that's what a lot of gamers do. They basically screen record their games. Hopefully that should be in better quality than before, because basically all I did was just stand at my TV screen and then place my iPad recorder in my gaming chair and then make the video and film it like that in front of the TV. But I don't think it's the best of quality like that, and plus I had some viewers comment by saying that, you know, screen recording is better and stuff like that, and I begin to have the habit of screen recording, so I thought I'd try this. And this is definitely a bit of a different approach that I have with this, so hopefully this will come out in better quality. And now, what I'm going to do to this is that I'm going to go ahead and test this out in a raid. So we're going to do Steel Cradle, which means we have to destroy a Leviathan from being built. That means we've got to destroy all kinds of booby traps and energy towers along the way. And watch out for the excess goons in the process that consistently respawn and try to attack you. I'm going to do the easy raid just to get the whole thing over with and just demonstrate how each of my builds work and what they do. And so those are my allies. And me, Sherverlandy, 94,000 is at the top. That's me. And when that meter, you can see on the bottom of the screen, lights up, I press X, and it activates my perk. And so, I can do this. It's green in color. Pretty decent, but you got to get up very close in order to deliver maximum damage. And so I got two daily challenges done, actually three, so I'm going to get more. But now I'm going to go ahead and test out another one of my builds. I have multiple builds that I made. And I'll constantly improve on them once I get more weapons and parts and stuff with him. And also, I forgot to tell you that the maximum durability of this is 1,685 points, which is pretty decent for a build like this. And that's pretty decently durable. Now, we'll go to my low power score truck, which this has five small machine guns right here. These are known as LM54 cords. They're not very powerful, but for a little quick skirmish and easy battles, they'll rip anything to shreds. You just gotta be very, very careful with them, because as YouTuber Mr. G says, these have the durability of wet toilet paper, and they're mounted on another cat in here, which I have a rare rarity right here. This is the Bear, which is, it looks similar to a GMC Sierra, kind of like that, like a GMC Sierra pickup truck. And I put the bed on the back of that there, and it's covered by extra truck doors and container walls and APC roof parts made of heavy steel. This one has, this one's a 4x4 with 56-inch tractor tires for agricultural use, and this has two front large thorns for frontal impact damage. So we're going to go ahead and go back to that same raid of steel cradle and test that out. This one's got a pretty decent amount of durability, even though this build is a lot smaller and not as powerful as my other builds. So then I'm going to wait to load and quickly get different allies. But my previous allies did a great job. It's all about teamwork in these raids, because you've got to have a good team. You got to have a good team with powerful builds, and if they get destroyed, they got to keep respawning and coming back, because if they don't, or if they have weak builds, then that's not a good team. So the raids in Crossout are a team-based strategy. It's all about teamwork in these raids. And this whole game is about teamwork. Because sometimes playing with randoms that you don't know, you may not know what they're really capable of or stuff like that. You just gotta be mindful of that. Okay, so the next one is starting. The next steel cradle. Now, if I did this on medium or hard, my build would get blown to bits, because the goons in this would be a lot more powerful and stronger and stuff, and would respond a lot quicker and more frequently. And that would make
it good. Soft gas, here they are!
So this is a nearly 3,000 power score, so that's what I call a low power score board. Now it's good enough for that board, for your drive, for this game. It's got some pretty decent armor. And durability, 759 points, it's pretty good. So,
yeah.
little armor, and they're very weak, structurally. As Mr. Z would say, they have a durability of that sort of paper, but their weapons are very, very powerful and strong, so you gotta be very careful. Okay, so that's done. And now for another build I'm going to try. This game's really fun if it lets you. But sometimes you may get paired up with either randoms that don't know what they're doing or just refuse to cooperate or any of that, or the enemies, the AI enemies, or the gamer enemies just act stupidly overpowered and try and get you instantly. So you gotta be careful about that. So, my next build, these are the co-drivers that you can get. I'm currently in the process of leveling up this one, Jade, all the way to 15, and once I do, I'm gonna unlock more perks for this and a lot of other co-drivers. Now my next build I'm gonna try out is my Mammoth Truck, which is one of my heavy cabin builds here. This is the Machinist Cabin. It's basically an electric subway locomotive train cabin, but it has an extra diesel engine to provide extra power and give extra mass movement and stuff like that. And it has these two cannons called Mammoths, ZS-46 Mammoths. They're very powerful, and they do 6 points of energy, so you can only mount two of them. But they're very heavy, so you got to be really, really careful about that. Also a 6x6x6 with the Bigfoot monster truck tires that all steer. And this one has a pretty decent amount of durability. 2016 durability points, that's pretty strong. Now, I did put extra... I did put a pretty decent amount of excessive weight on here, so the max speed is about 58 kilometers an hour, so it's a little bit slower than before. So the speed's in kilometers. Now, my other two builds that I just tested, my Remedy build could go a little over 100 kilometers, whereas my Cord low power score build can go about 75 kilometers an hour. And so this is 15 points of energy, but this is 12, so I have two of these cannons mounted. So for 6 points of energy, plus I have ammo packs that further increase the ammunition on here. Now the thing is, you gotta follow the target and aim as you're firing this, because it's best to use this at long range, because it's really hard to use this at short range. And plus, these cannons are susceptible to bullet drop. So the shells actually drop in an arc as they're shot. So your shot may not accurately land on the target that you're trying to hit. So you gotta lead it somehow. That's the bit of the tricky part on using this kind of build. And I'm gonna use the same steel cradle rate again. Sometimes this may take a little bit to load in. It does get annoying sometimes. Good thing about Steel Cradle on easy mode is you get it done within a matter of a few short minutes, and that's it. That's like the quickest raid you can do. I would not recommend you do this on medium or hard. I mean, you can do it on medium pretty okay, but I would not recommend doing it on hard because, as I mentioned before, the enemies just keep on respawning and they are a lot stronger and more powerful and they will keep swarming you like crazy. So I wouldn't really recommend it. Plus the Leviathan that you gotta get is stupidly strong. So it's built differently than the Leviathan in this one. So this one is, this build here is 11,387 points of power score, which is actually really good. your build is over 10,000 power score, then you're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have
a bunch of them around here.
And 32 rounds, and 11 rounds, 32 rounds, 10,000 power score, then you're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this. You're going to have a good time with this as well to give it extra power, as well as another 1,000 kilograms of mass. So you'll mainly hear that diesel engine going there. which that's called the Hot Red. It's a turbocharged four-cylinder diesel engine. I can't tell if it's a Deutz or a Cummins, but it's pretty decent though. And it's got very good tonnage, 9,100 kilograms and 26,400 kilograms of mass limit. 11 points of energy, so that's 15 points of energy with the generator mounted on here. So the perk is, for each 1,000 points of the armored vehicle's durability, increases the durability of the weapons mounted on the cabin by 8%. So this mammoth cannon mounted here on the cabin has durability increased by 8%. You don't see it, but the cannon on top of here will be a lot more durable. And that will prevent it from getting blown off instantly. And maximum bonus is 25%, so I'm guessing this could theoretically be 8% more durable, although you don't really see it in the durability right there. But this cannon's actually really durable. Okay, so now I'll go into my other builds that I have here. One of my personal favorites is my Nidhogg truck. So on this build, I have four reload action shotguns known as Nidhoggs, which are very powerful and have very high damage output. But the thing is, just like the Remedy flamethrowers, you have to get up super close in range to make them work effectively. And I got four of these, so that will deliver a lot of damage. You just got to get up really close to the target to deliver your four-shot salvo with these. And before this build looked like it does now, I had a light cabin on here that served it pretty well for a while, but it really wasn't as good as I thought. It was the Cerberus cabin, which is a hot rod style cabin with a little drilling cone. I think it's a tricone cutting head drill bit on the front. It's used for close melee combat, but it wasn't very durable and it kept getting shot easily, and it wasn't very powerful, and it was very weak in durability. So I have a better cabin here, which I will show here at the top here, which I have covered up in protection. This is called the Omnibox. It's kind of like a construction machine style cabin from ultra-modern special machinery. It could be like a crane or an excavator or stuff like that, powered by a diesel engine. I don't know what kind, but it's definitely a diesel engine. And it's not very fast. It goes up to 68 kilometers an hour, which is all right, but it's only 8 kilometers an hour faster than the Machinist heavy cabin that I have installed. But this has two different perks. So the first mode perk increases the maximum cabin speed by 10% and the power of the cabin by 20%. The second mode accelerates the cooling by 15% and weapons reloading by 15%. So with these paired up on this, you get decent reloading with this, which is pretty good. And it's got 7,150 tonnage and 12,500 mass limit, which is actually pretty decent. And this is a medium cabin with 12 points of energy and a decent durability right there. Overall durability is 2,860 points. Now that is a lot of durability right here. A lot more than that of the mammoth truck build that I have. Then again, it's the same six-wheel drive, 6x6 monster truck steering tires as the other few builds I mentioned, but this one has a lot more steel and aluminum structural parts, increasing its durability and protecting its cabin. Some of these are heavy machinery parts, and some of these are military vehicle parts. And here, these are pike tooth. These are little spikes that I made as a makeshift bumper. So, kind of like on the bare GMC truck cabin, if I run into an enemy goon right in front of me, I could deliver maximum damage to him just by driving straight into him. And so I only have one of the Nidhoggs mounted here on the cabin, whereas the other Nidhogg is mounted here on these two steel structural parts here, same with these other two here. And now, sorry, I just got a Facebook notification there. That's my bad. I'm going to go ahead and test this out back in the steel cradle RAID. Oh, wow. Started instantly. And this one will be a lot stronger and a lot more powerful at close range. Oh, well, look at that. I have 2,000 power score. Okay. So now it's at more power and higher speed mode. Now I'm going to press on. Over there. 2860 durability points, that's pretty good. It's actually really, really durable. So these actually did get a buff in a recent record. So these shotguns are a lot more powerful than they used to be. And now, I'm going to be able to disable the two motors one last time.
He's down.
Which my allies will help me help with as well. There's more boons. Let's get care of these guys really quick. I'll definitely make more Crossout videos. I mean, I'm not making a lot of Snowrunner videos, and a few Forza videos here.
Not your best effort, but it's all right.
And this build did great. This is actually one of my favorite builds to use. It's a lot better than it used to be. And I also have another medium cabin that I might try on this build at a later date with a different perk. Basically, I'm just going to keep experimenting and see which one is best for me. Like, which parts to use are best for me and stuff like that. You know, it's all about figuring out what you think works best for you. Everyone's got their own styles and ideas of certain builds and what their build should be and how durable they want it to be and how powerful they want it to be, etc., etc. So now, I'm going to go to another pre-built vehicle that one of my Xbox Live friends actually pre-assembled for me. However, I included the same Nidhogg shotguns on it. Oops. This one is like a wedge build, because wedge builds used to be really, really popular in meta. Like, they used to be really popular meta builds in Crossout, but they got nerfed recently, so I don't know how they'll still do. But this is a different cabin. This is a car cabin. I think it's like a, it looks like something from a Volkswagen Beetle, I think, or something like that. It's called the Griffin. And its perk is, when activated, the player and three closest allies in the 25-meter range are invisible on radar and become immune to the effects of Oculus and Verifier radars for 11 seconds, and the cooldown is 20 seconds. Goes 95 kilometers top speed, 9,000 mass limit, 4,800 kilograms, 12 points of energy. It's a light cabin, but it's a decent light cabin. It's a legendary light cabin. I mean, I don't know how effective its perk is, but it's pretty different. But with the other diesel engine that I have installed, it will go about 107 kilometers. So that's a bit more powerful than before. I'll go ahead and test this out. Now, with wedge builds, they used to be really annoying to fight against. So the build would just drive up underneath another build and fork it up and then shoot underneath it to get stuff like the fuel tanks or generators or cabins instantly, just like that, and hold it there until the enemy build is destroyed. And I've went up against those before, and they're no fun. So hopefully this nerf might, you know, do something different to them. I don't know how they'll act, but I'm just gonna try it on these goons and Steel Cradle and see what happens. I don't know how different it'll be, but we'll have to wait and see. Steel Cradle again, once again, battling the enemy Leviathan. As with the previous build that I mentioned with my same Nidhogg shotguns, you gotta get up very close in range to deal maximum damage. But with this, it may be a bit different, so we'll have to try a different method by actually driving onto these enemies and get trapped on my wedge, and then
this one, all right.
this one, and I survived. I barely survived that one. Yeah, I don't think these wedge builds have that good of durability. You just got to use them in that kind of mannerism. They could be satisfying to play, but annoying to fight against, if you know what I mean. Sometimes it could be a little bit tricky, though. But it depends on how good a driver you are at that. So, I haven't really played wedges that much, so that's just me. And this one's got 1689 points of durability, so it's decent. So it's not as good as some of my other builds, but it's okay at least. And I got three other builds I'm gonna display here. This is one of my personal favorites, the Airbitter truck. This has four mini guns called Airbitters, MG14 Airbitters. Their damage is amazing, although not very strong at first. However, their perk is, the longer the weapon fires, the higher the damage. After 7 seconds of uninterrupted fire, the damage of your weapon here increases by 150%, which is a lot. Now, four of these pack a really heavy punch. Now, the thing is, these heat up pretty quickly. So, to increase their overheat time, I've installed radiators, which are RN seals. These increase the overheating by 70%, and the effect stacks, which is awesome. So this is actually about, I believe, 280% total of uninterrupted fire, which is a lot. That's a lot of time for these miniguns to be firing. And of course, they're on the same Omnibox machinery cabin. Also with the excess steel and aluminum structural parts here that I have installed. Also 6x6x6 with the Bigfoot Monster Truck steering tires. And now going back to steel cradle. Now each raid changes within every hour, so you got to go within a certain hour time frame if you want to get the most out of a certain raid, or if you want to do as many of that raid as you want. But when that hour is up, then the raid changes. Now with this build, you can actually stay at a pretty far distance away from the enemies that you're fighting. You could deal very good damage from medium to long range, and you won't even have to worry about shotguns or flamethrowers blowing you to bits at the time. In this case, with the Lunatics, which is the enemy faction that you're fighting. Like my mid-hog shotguns, I have these broadsides, so I need to turn them in any direction like this to deal as much damage as I can using all four of the miniguns, just like it was with the shotguns. And the heavy shotgun, generators again. These are the allies. Careful, because these goons keep respawning every turn, which is really annoying. It's the consistent spawning of these goons that really makes this more difficult in a humane way. But it's better on easy mode like this. This is actually a very satisfying build to use. If I used an Aurora laser gun, then I would not be able to have four of these Airbiter miniguns on there. So then again, this cabin has the 16 energy limit with the 12 energy base of the cabin, plus the 4 points of energy with the Apollo generator that I have installed. I have that same generator on all my builds. And 28 and 2732 points of durability. It's not quite as durable as the Nidhogg version of this, but it's still got a pretty decent amount of durability. And it goes 77 kilometers an hour max, which is pretty decent actually. And now we'll go to another similar build with the similar design, except it's got a few different parts on it. This is called the Caucasus truck. This has 4 automatic targeting autocannons called Caucasuses. I mean, the names are a little hard to pronounce. Some say Caucasus, others say Caucasuses, or what. It's a little hard to butcher and pronounce sometimes, so. But that's what these are. These have 284 points of durability, 4 points of energy, decent mass. And the perk is, these automatically attack the selected target. You do not have to do anything. All you have to do is just press the targeting fire button and then let the cannons do the work. But they have less range than the Airbiter miniguns, so we gotta be careful with that. And this actually has decent durability. Well, not as durability as some of the other ones. This is 2421 points of durability and a 10,500 power score, so it's not that bad compared to some of the other builds. Now, this one is a 12,973 for the Airbiter truck, 13,868 for the Nidhogg Wedger, and 12,873 for the Nidhogg truck, and all that, 9,710 for the Remedy truck, and all that. And so I'll go ahead and test this out in the same Steel Cradle battle. This might be the last time I do Steel Cradle, because the next one is going to change, because the next hour is coming up within the next 5 minutes. So I'm going to do one more raid after this, but it might be a bit different than this, so we'll have to wait and see. But all easy raids are the same, so they both offer a certain amount of copper. So you get between 20 to 30 units of copper after these easy raids and stuff, depending on how you do and how your allies do and stuff like that. Here, and we got two others that are just starting to spawn in. save of the generators.
First contact. Another enemy destroyed.
Has changed, so now I'm going to do another easy raid with one more final build that I have and another one of my personal favorites that I've been starting to use and I'm still trying to get used to because this is a brand new build that I just recently made and it's actually really, really fun to use. And I'll show here. It's this monster, the Retro Truck. This one is loaded with armor and has two four-barrel grenade launchers, which fire a total of 8 grenades toward the enemies. Now, just like cannons, these suffer from bullet drops, so you have to lead the target and making sure the grenades will literally hit the target. You gotta aim it in different ways. Sometimes, like, you gotta aim it upwards and stuff like that to get maximum range. Now, it says the further the target, the higher the damage. For every 100 meters to the current target, the damage increases by a whopping 230%. Now, that's a lot of damage. Just like Phil Swift with Flex Seal and Flex Tape would say, you know, you get the idea. And it's mounted on the same machinist train cabin, subway electric locomotive cabin, also with the hot red diesel engine, that's what it's called, which gives it 1,000 extra tonnage, kilograms, and all that. And this has a lot more steel and aluminum structural parts on there. And these grenade launchers will now have a lot more durability than what they normally would be. So I'm guessing it's an increase of 16% or so, since this is an 8% of a perk with all mounted weapons. So this could be 16%, I believe. So it looks pretty decent. Plus it's got some spikes on here that can obliterate any enemy if it runs toward it and stuff like that. Also with a 6x6x6, with the Bigfoot monster truck tires that all steer. And however, these grenades offer a different kind of firing mechanism. So once they fire, they are reload based and they overheat as they fire. So you gotta wait for them to cool down as well, which can be annoying, but that could be alleviated with coolers and stuff. But instead of that, I have radiators. Actually, no. I have ammo packs to increase, its ammo capacity, and I have radiators to further increase the time that these overheat. But these are ridiculous, so which is really cool. And this build has the most durability out of all my other builds. This one has a whopping 3,142 points of durability, which is very, very strong. And right now at 17,350 kilograms, 15 points of energy, 64 kilometers an hour max, which is pretty decent, actually. It's a lot faster than that of the Mammoth Cannon truck as well. Now, let's see what other easy rates we have. Oh, it looks like we have another steel cradle. This will be a breeze, since these grenades can easily wipe out multiple enemy units in a matter of seconds and deliver massive damage. Now, I wouldn't recommend using these at close range, because you got to aim them right. It's all about the aiming when it comes to these, just like cannons. It does get a little crazy, but these are some of the best weapons to use in raids or mission battles or whatnot, or just about any mode, because these wretchers are some of the best weapons to use, period, in this game. I mean, they deliver so much damage in a small amount of time, it's crazy. But it's all about aiming them right. You gotta aim them right, just like the cannons. So we gotta get that Leviathan one last time. Okay, here we go. And now my allies are loading up. And we're at a different location this time. Rapid comms. It's the air brakes of my base.
Targets, the bad guy. And
good for medium and hard roads, as well as mission tasks. These are really good for that. I see tons of goods with these retro grenade launchers. And these are just monsters. They can destroy anything that they touch. Now I'm having a heavy revival. It should be a piece of cake with my retro grenade launchers. These are those, so let me see how they get close to them. Impressive. This is one of my personal favorite builds that I've made, and it's awesome. And the generator is actually mounted right underneath the rear four Bigfoot monster truck tires, so hopefully something shouldn't get hit there. But I don't think anyone should attack me from behind, but if they do, I'll be ready. But still, this is a pretty crazy build. I love it. It took me a while to make, but it came out really good, and I'm definitely going to keep this in my arsenal. But also, I'm working on crafting other builds and weapons, and maybe getting other cabins for some more builds that I'm making. So I'm going to go over here to factions. I'm with the Dawn's Children right now, and so I'm working on crafting three more Gravistar laser guns. These are like shotguns, so they heat up and stuff, but they deal a lot of damage. The perk of this is after the weapon overheats, it receives the heating effect until the next shot. This shot heats up the enemy parts on impact. It only has 196 durability points and 4 points of energy, but still, combining four of these onto one build, and you put a ton of radiators on there, it would be really OP. So I'm in the middle of crafting this right now for another build. And now there's one more build that I'll show off, but you can't really use it in a game mode of any kind, but you can only use it in clan battles, as well as these little other battles known as, I'll show you. This is the Leviathan that I have. The Leviathan is kind of like what I fought in Steel Cradle. However, you can put as many weapons on here as you want, and you can build it however you want. This has 7,000 kilograms of a mass, 70,000 kilograms of a mass limit, and 65 points of energy, and you can put 180 parts on here. And this has over 7,000 durability points, but I may work on tinkering with it, building with it a little bit more and stuff, but you can deploy it in a battle, which I'll show you momentarily. So, I don't see it anywhere on here. But before I do, I'm going to demonstrate it. So the Leviathan fires on its own. It automatically targets the enemy. So you just fall through the enemy, and it automatically targets and fires. You don't have to press any buttons. You just get it close to these enemies, and it will do the work on its own. And it's got cannons, machine guns, flamethrowers, and shotguns. So the cabin is the Bastion, which is a Caterpillar Tractor Bulldozer style cabin. And it's a heavy cabin. It's epic though. And it's got decent tonnage and mass and durability. And the perk is this gigantic steel plow blade at the front, which it says the blade at the cabin's front boosts increased resistance to all types of damage except energy damage. Which is good. But if you're going up against energy weapons or flame weapons, then you know, you're not going to have a good time with this. But it'll block missiles and bullets and shells and cannons, and it'll block all that. It'll have increased resistance to that. Now, you can deploy it. I'm going to press deploy. It will deploy it in another battle, which I'll show you here. I'm going to switch back to my grenade launcher truck, my retro truck. And so, you actually fight custom-made Leviathans made by other gamers in this raid here, which is called an invasion. This uses up 40 liters of fuel versus the easy raids, which do 20 liters of fuel. And the medium raids also do 20 liters of fuel. But if you do hard raids, that's 60 liters of fuel. Now, the invasion is where you actually fight Leviathans made by other gamers in this game. So I'm sending off my Leviathan in this battle here. So if it gets destroyed, it gets sent back to my garage. And it has within a day to complete these invasions. Now, if it wins, then I get copper from it automatically. I don't have to physically be in this invasion. But I can be in this invasion in one of my other builds, my normal armored builds, with other gamer allies fighting other Leviathans, which I can also get copper at the end of this, which is kind of interesting, actually. And yeah, so that's what I've been doing on Crossout. I've been grinding a lot, so it's all about grinding. So you got to grind a lot to get good on this game. Sometimes, you know, you can buy other packs of coins or builds or whatever to win, but yeah, or you could just wait to win and stuff, or like wait to grind and stuff like that. So, you know, it's interesting in its own way. And my method of grinding is getting a lot of plastic, which I will sell to craft other resources and stuff. And I also have copper, which in this case I'll sell. And other scrap metal, which I'll also sell. You can either sell these as is, or you can wait to use these to craft other parts or resources or whatnot. And there's a lot you can do with this. It's interesting. And I have 416 coins and counting, and I'll be getting more as I go along. So yeah, hope you all enjoyed this new video I have of Crossout, and I'll definitely make more Crossout videos in the future. And I'll also make more SnowRunner and Forza videos as well, so stay tuned. Please like and subscribe, and yeah, hope you all enjoyed this new video of Crossout.